Moses was the traditional author of the first five books of the Bible, called the Pentateuch, or the Torah, or the Law. Now, Exodus to Deuteronomy, Moses could have written them because he was an eyewitness to the events. But Genesis is about events far before Moses was born. We see this chiasm going all the way through this flood account, and the central part is what the chiasm is focusing on. God remembers Noah. Now, does God forget things? Well, no. Remembering in the Hebrew meant that God began to act on his behalf again. God's providence was helping Noah and the ark animals survive the flood. And God said, let there be light. And there was light. And God saw that it was good. You've got over 20 vav consecutives in Genesis 1 alone. This is very clear evidence that Genesis was intended to be taken as historical narrative. It's not poetry. It's not allegory. A very important topic here is about how Scripture is often the best interpreter of itself. So if we want to understand how Genesis is meant to be understood, let's see how the rest of the Bible understands it. So the whole basis of our working week is based on Creation Week. Now, since we work for 6 days and don't work for 6 billion years, I'd say the creation days have to be 6 ordinary days as well. Otherwise, this command makes no sense at all. And it had to be working in history. It's supposed to be an example for us to work in history, is that God worked in history over Creation Week. So it's a real act of historical creation over historical literal days. If we can't trust the Bible on earthly things, which includes creation in 6 ordinary days and a global flood, why should we trust it on the heavenly things, which includes Jesus as God and Savior? And we see Genesis is historical narrative. It is not poetry, very clearly. It's history. The rest of Scripture takes Genesis as historical narrative. It doesn't treat it as allegorical or poetic. It treats all the characters, all the events, and even the order of events as historical, real history. So I hope you've enjoyed the second session. So do come back for the third session, where we're going to discuss day one of Creation Week, more detail on the creation days, and the very controversial question, how old is the earth?